Greetings, meeting on the Mesa attendees. My name is Nick Venusos. I'm CEO of Opsis Therapeutics. And today I'm going to take you through an overview of our company, our pipeline, our product development. We have three programs that we have, but today I'm going to specifically talk about two of them. And finally, go into a little more depth on our in vivo studies, our animal models for both those two programs. About us, Opsis Therapeutics was founded in 2016. We're a joint venture with Fujifilm, companies based in Madison, Wisconsin. Therapeutically, we focus in three areas for inherited retinal diseases, inherited macular degeneration, and age-related macular degeneration. What sets us apart, our team has developed methods to manufacture authentic, highly pure, highly scalable, fully cryopreservable, and rigorously tested. I'm going to show you how rigorously we tested our photoreceptors in RP later in the presentation, but rigorously tested. And what inspires us is the potential for our programs for patients suffering from permanent vision loss to have a dramatic improvement. So who we are from a specific team standpoint, we've got our management team, which is me on the left. One notable on the left is Dr. David Gamm, well-known pediatric ophthalmologist, but also an innovator in the area of cell therapies for degenerative diseases of the retina. Carter Cliff, entrepreneur in cell therapy, and last two, Lucas Chase and Joe Phillips, are responsible for a majority of the content of this presentation. They're the ones doing the work and making things happen. Over on the right, you have our world-class scientific advisory board, including Kapil Bharti from the NEI, world-renowned surgeon, Steve Charles, and stem cell pioneer, Jamie Thompson, among others. So we think we have a broad strategy, and the reason we think we have a broad strategy, so look over in the pie chart on the right, so there are many genetic causes of inherited retinal diseases. On the bottom, you note RPE65, which Luxturna solves for. But we believe cell therapy, including our programs, offer a broad strategy for perhaps maybe the only strategy for late-stage dry AMD. So now let's talk about our pipeline and frame up the rest of the presentation. So cell source on the left, all our programs are allogeneic. We're targeting off-the-shelf allogeneic solutions for the diseases that we target. Starting with the top row for the diseases, inherited retinal diseases area, the cell type is a photoreceptor precursor. So this is our 001 program. In our 001 program, we're targeting mid-2022 for our IND. Middle for late-stage AMD. This is our dual product. So we've got an RPE and a photoreceptor precursor on scaffold, our 002 product, about 1 year behind the lead program and with a mid-2023 IND. And then finally, we have, I don't specifically note again, this is an allogeneic program for early AMD, our RPE mono on scaffold, our 003 program. Through our partnership with the NEI and leveraging their autologous approach, we're hoping to bridge to a phase two by mid-2024. So this is a slide, we call this our development wheel. This highlights all the capabilities that we've developed in time related to our ocular programs, and I'll highlight a couple of these. Starting at the top of the wheel with our iPSC platform, through our partnership with Fujifilm, 13 years of iPSC experience platform development. We've developed optimal GMP iPSC processes, and therefore this enables robust ocular cell manufacturing. We've done extensive lead op, very iterative process of multiple identification of multiple candidates, and we take those candidates and we immediately move over to in vivo studies in a second and we test. So very iterative. Develop, test. So this has given us high quality lead op candidates. All the way to the bottom of the wheel process scale up, we're not working towards just the next batch. We have a long-term strategy in mind to develop, and we're pushing towards scale-up culture systems, including cell factories and disposable bioreactors. And finally, again, as I mentioned, continuing around the wheel, almost to the top with in vivo studies. Again, very iterative process. And you can see here, we're doing testing not only in small rats, but we're also doing large pig and dog testing. I'll show you more about that later in the presentation. So we have an iPSC-derived platform, and we start with a donor blood sample. And then we use our proprietary episomal reprogramming technology and capabilities to create footprint-free cells. And then we direct differentiation. We direct our differentiation using exogenous factors such as media and molecules. We purify, and we have a proprietary differentiated process that leads us in the end to a cryopreserved therapeutic product. So again, strong IP. Multiple aspects of this are highly proprietary. Differentiating iPSCs all the way down to a photoreceptor precursor is not easy. It's complex and it takes a long period of time. But not only have we solved for this differentiation process, but we've actually created a process which is tunable. So we can tune our rod versus cone, and this is very important. Our rod versus cone ratio, and this is very important for receptor cell therapies. Transitioning over to a little bit of a deeper dive again on two of our programs, our 001 program to start. So this again, refresher, this is our photoreceptor precursor for inherited retinal diseases. Let's start with process development and scale up. Again, we had a long-term view in mind. Over on the left, you see the graphic, the four box, if you will. Our multi-layer cell factories, transitioning over to disposable PBS bioreactor systems, again, continuing to scale up. Multeni, Clinimax cell enrichment below the bioreactor picture. And finally, we wrap things up with our ATS closed system filling capabilities. Moving over to the right side of the slide, you can see I've used the word extensive in the past. Back this up by saying when you look at the development achievements to date related to our 001 program, 450 experiments, 1,500 differentiations. We're well over 45 scale-up development, close to knocking on 50 now, 100 billion cryopreserved 001 cells, and we're looking at over 500 patient doses per run. Again, robust long-term view. This is a picture of what 50 billion cells looks like in PBS bioreactor. Okay, continuing with characterization from an 001 standpoint, looking at post-thaw gene and protein expression analysis, we've confirmed an enriched phenotype of the photoreceptor with minimal off-target and very few proliferative cells. Below that, you can see we've done single-cell RNA-seq, which confirms our committed rod and cone phenotype. And in the graphic below, you can see we have a small population of other neurons. Final thing I'd like to say is just note the number of replicates in our analysis. LEADOP, as I mentioned previously, develop tests. When you're looking at the S334-TER rat model, 3 months. Again, we're looking from a cone differentiation, a rod differentiation standpoint. We're looking at good 90% transplanted cells are photoreceptors consisting of both rods and cones. We've done over 300 rat transplantations to date. Again, reiterating our rod-cone ratio is tunable. Continuing on in rats, we've got over time, 6-9 months, we've got good inner and outer segment formation. Our rods are trafficking rhodopsin to the outer segments, and our outer segments are looking, again, stable in the long run. From now transitioning to pig, in partnership with our NEI and a laser damaged pig model, you can see we've developed an optimized surgical procedure to deliver the 001 to patients. And transplantation of those cells shows excellent distribution and survival. maturation in pig models from a photoreceptor degeneration standpoint. We also, as I mentioned before, are testing in the dog model. And with our partnership and collaboration with the University of Pennsylvania, looking at their RCD1 dog model, the retinitis pigmentosa, our 001 integrates well into the degenerative host. And we've observed survival and maturation in both rods and cones along the way. We're planning on also in the future taking this SCD1 dog model, doing functional testing. Now let's transition to the second program of the three, and that's our 002 program. This is an iPSC-derived RPE and photoreceptor combination therapy, or we call our bilayer therapy for AMD. Let's start with the RPE part of the bilayer. Robust process development efforts here. Looking at the bottom graph, we can see the black line is pre-purification, the green line is post-purification, so we have a highly pure product here and robust and consistent across over 116 different patients and 29 iPSC lines, 13 different donors. Consistent, robust, highly pure product. GMP compatible manufacturing process that's been optimized. And then finally, this protocol will be used in the clinical manufacturing for the NEI's autologous IND program. So NEI is taking advantage of the work that we've done as well. Again, this is a bilayer product. So we not only have RPE, we have a photoreceptor as well. We've got a graph showing mature RPE growing on an electrospun PLG scaffold with an enriched photoreceptor overlay. So this is what we call our bilayered product. In the center, you see the transplantation device. So we're delivering this product using an IND-approved transplantation tool developed with the NEI for their autologous program. Again, in partnership with the NEI, we've done transplantation in a pig model for AMD. So we've got reliable, over on the left, you can see optimized delivery of the construct developed and optimized. We've got a scaffold which degrades nicely in vivo and is well tolerated by the whole retina. And we've got robust and organized replacement of RPE and photoreceptors in the pig model. So good results. Again, over time, the photoreceptor and the photoreceptor matures into rods and cones nicely along, and the RPE and the photoreceptors integrate well over time, looking at about 3 months data here. In summary, Opsys has developed robust, authentic, rigorously tested programs for inherited retinal diseases and dry AMD. Our lead product is approaching IND. We're about 2022. One thing I didn't mention is we have a new state-of-the-art GMP facility ready to support our programs through our partnership with Fujifilm. We're not a one-trick pony. We have multiple solutions here for patients, three programs, in fact, for patients suffering from vision loss. We have a strong, experienced team and a leading SAB, a world-class SAB. We estimate to get all three programs to those IND dates that I mentioned previously, costing about $55 to $60 million. And that also includes prepping manufacturing for those anticipated phase one trials. And we have, final statement is we are in the process of partnering and we have initiated discussions on partnering our programs. Thank you very much.